and blowing up those shoes.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and Merry Christmas. It is Christmas made at the market here at the market on Madison, and we've got some wonderful vendors here that have so many great arts and crafts and food. And we've got this wonderful lady here, Beth, with us. Hi, Beth.
Hey.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Now, Beth, talk to us a little bit about you and your business and how long you've been doing this, and what does it feel like for you to be out here?
So I have done the Christmas Main Market. This is my third year, so this is our third annual, so I've done it every year. I make all natural items using essential oils, and I use doTERRA, so we're using a God-made, not a man-made. Mm-hmm. We have Christmas certain items that you can get with like diffuser bombs, and then also just different kind of like pain, aches, and stuff all. And then as far as the other vendors, like you have anything from baked goods to candles, homemade elderberry, wood items. I mean, literally, you can do all your shopping here this weekend.
Love that. Now, Beth, so you're literally a natural chemist.
Yes.
So to speak.
Yeah. My business name is Beth Wood, Natural Guru.
I love that.
Yes.
And so, you know, as you can see, there's so many great products here that come from you, honey. Your hand.
Yes.
What made you get into business like this?
So I want to show people that we have options and we don't have to use pharmaceuticals and over-the-counter products. God left this to work optimally, and it's up to us of what we put in and around that body.
Wonderful. I got to see what you got over here, Beth.
Yes,
I got to see
yes,
what you got over here. And so, Beth, anything else you want to say to the people out there? Because, I mean, this, you know, the pandemic has really caused us to have to not only to see things differently, but to just conduct business a little differently. And so how does it feel to be out here in the fresh air for Christmas Made at the Market?
It is amazing. And just to be able to get that fellowship with other people.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Beth Wood. We've got Elaine and her dad with her here. This is so precious. Elaine's Kitchen. How are you two doing?
Good. Very good.
Now listen, Elaine, talk to us a little bit about you and your business and how long you've been coming out here.
Well, I've been coming out to the market since May. My mother passed away in March, his wife, and so we needed something to fill that void.
Yeah.
And so the market on Madison has become our family.
Mm-hmm.
We love it. It's open from April till the end of October.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're so excited to be here this weekend because
yeah.
it's like a family reunion. And I started baking again.
Mm-hmm.
And I used my main thing is my mother's cream cheese pound cake. And that was her favorite recipe.
Oh, that is so special. Dad, tell us who you are. Tell us your name and talk to us about the business that your daughter has. And of course, the memory, the memorial she's doing to honor your wife with her recipe.
Well, after Marjorie died, we got busy doing craft, and I do woodwork. She does cooking and baking, and so I just enjoy doing it. It kept me busy, kept my mind off of her.
And what's lovely is how the family legacy of where you're still, you know, you're still a close-knit family, and the legacy of your mom, your wife, still lives on in the work that you do with your hands.
That's right. We enjoy it, too.
Anything you want to say to the people of Dublin out there? Because, you know, it has really been a tough time for our families. You all have just experienced that personally. And it's such a blessing to be able to come out amongst, you know, our families out here, our community, to be able to partake in something like this.
I don't think we realized how much we missed social interaction.
Yeah.
And that you can feel it in the air. There's Christmas music. Everybody's in a good mood. We all need each other, especially this time of the year. We're all missing someone. Most of us have lost a family member. And let's just all join together and be happy and share joy.
Very good. Dad, anything?
We're looking for a big crowd tomorrow. Big crowd.
Thank you both so much.
Thank you.
We've got Annette Taylor with us, one of my colleagues. How are you?
I'm good. How are you, ma'am?
Doing well. Now, listen, you know, you don't ever know how talented a person is just from sitting at a desk or driving a school bus. Annette, you have a gift and talent that I just recently found out about. Share with us about what you like to do on your spare time.
It's called Sewn Treasures by Annette. I do crochet. I do quilting. Memory quilts, memory bears, I can't sit still. I have to have something in my hands working all the time.
And so, where did you learn how to do all this?
My grandmother.
Grandmother.
I've been doing this since I was like 6 years old.
Oh my gosh, and now here it is, it's coming to fruition. Are any of your relatives still alive that have taught you these things?
Yes, My aunt, yes.
How special is that for you?
Very fortunate, yes, very fortunate.
So for you to be able to be out here, how does it feel for you to be able to set up your little shop here and mingle with our community?
This is one of the things when COVID, right after COVID hit, that brought me closer to the town because, you know, I had just moved here. And it's like one big happy family because most of these folks are out here. They have been out here for a while, and we just, you know, we love it. You know, we love it.
And, you know, as I'm looking at some of your stuff, I'm like, I think I paid good money for one of these just the other day that looks exactly like this. And so, you know, and Annette, when you talk about being able to come together and we share about so many things, so many ups and downs that we've experienced, not just as a community, but for a nation. What do you want to say to the people out there of Dublin, Lawrence County?
Just love everybody. Say something kind. I read something this morning that if you can say one kind thing to somebody at least once a day, it spreads. So, you know, just love each other.
It's definitely spreading with you. It's always a pleasure to see you, and I love working with you.
I love working with you, too.
Annette Taylor. We've got two missionaries here from Sandersville, Rhonda and John. How are you guys this evening?
We're just wonderful.
Now listen, now when you're talking about arts and crafts and the love that goes into it, you guys have something out here that you can really explain to the people of Dublin, Lawrence County, the love of how this came to pass. You want to start us off?
Sure. Okay. All of these crafts were made for the indigenous women of Costa Rica. And every bit of the money goes to help them support their families and keep them working. So there's coffee bean jewelry, they knitted a lot of things, painted, coffee soap, everything is to support them and made by them.
Love that. Now, John, talk to us a little bit about this missionary field that you two have been
on. Sure.
And how long?
We've been serving in Costa Rica for 7 years now. And we've been working with the Nobis for most of that time. That's the indigenous group we work with. And they are the primary harvesters of the coffee crop in Costa Rica. Thus, the one of the first crafts we had them making was jewelry with roasted coffee beans. But since then, we've expanded into things like reusable market bags. And this is a traditional... This is a traditional bag called a chakra, and they use these in all sizes to carry fruit that they've picked, or even big enough that they put their babies in.
Oh, you know, perfect for cell phones.
Oh
for
yeah,
us.
Yeah.
For
the States.
Listen, John, I was gonna say, well, my 23-year-old won't fit. Love that. And you know, and it's and what you're talking about here is something that I know is dear to so many people's hearts here in Dublin, Lawrence County, because we've got so many that are on that mission field. You've got so many kids, students that are doing mission trips. And so anything.
We have an intern from Dublin who has been serving with us, Zoe
and
Von
who
Holton.
Is that?
Zoe Von Holton. She just came back. She was here just a minute ago, but she served four months with us.
Very good. Well, thank you both so much for all that you do
thank you.
For the great cause and what it does. That it truly does change lives.
That's right.
Thank you, Rhonda.
Thank you,
John.
Allen's Heating and Cooling is your licensed Amana equipment dealer. Trust Allen's Heating and Cooling to install and service your heating and cooling unit. Allen services all brands and with the purchase of a new Amana, offers a lifetime compressor warranty. Call Sean Clark or any of his friendly staff at Allen's Heating and Cooling, your Amana dealer. Amana lasts and lasts and lasts.
You've got miles and miles of grass to mow. So you're going to need a machine built to perform day in and day out, season after season. You're going to need a Gravely built to mow the distance.
Find your new Gravely mower at Myers Equipment and Supply, 301 North Jefferson in Dublin.
You know, we're having a great time tonight here. I mean, when you see all of the different arts and crafts and the people out here enjoying actually being out, I mean, it's exciting. We've got AJ over here with Teen Challenge to my right. How's it going,
AJ?
Doing?
It's going well. I'm blessed. I'm alive.
Good to see you.
Amen.
That means a lot. That carries a lot of weight, doesn't it?
It sure does.
It sure does. And we've got my girl Madeline here. Madeline Gay is a senior at West Orange High School, and she's actually a snowman tonight. And you're actually going to be able to let Madeline do a few interviews, and you're going to hear from her. How's it going, Madeline?
It's going great. I love it out here. It's great to see all the kids out here. They're really enjoying the amount of kids that have come up to me and asked to take pictures. It really warms my heart, and it makes the Christmas season the best it can be.
It really does. Now, AJ, so you can already tell she and I are excited. Talk to us a little bit about Teen Challenge and what you guys have out here.
We're selling braces. We're raising public awareness for the Ministry of Teen Challenge. We're recovering addicts. Soap, braces. I'm
stumbling over something. I know, that's okay. Do you make any of these things yourself, AJ?
We do not. The female center does. Okay.
And so here it is, you are part of the male center, and you are really proof positive that this program works, right?
It sure does. It helps me put together my testimony and gain a more intimate relationship with the Lord, our Father and our Lord Savior, Jesus Christ. I'm thankful that I got this instead of what I should have gotten, death. I should have been in a grave, but
sure. The
Lord has given me another chance.
He's a God of second chances.
Yes,
and here it is, you know, you've lived to tell about it. We're here to witness that. You're able to be here out tonight just to be a witness for others about what God can do in your life.
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. I'm going to speak a little bit of my testimony. I don't want to take up too much of your time, but I was Christmas Eve 2018. I was in a car accident. I didn't know I woke up in a hospital bed 2019, February, looking up, being restrained to a bed, looking up at a hospital room ceiling, didn't know how I got there. Didn't know what was going on. Being told, hey, do you know how you got here? Do you know what happened? Saying no. They told me I was in a car accident. Never been in a car accident in my life, so I mean, it kind of surprised me. But list out my injuries: broken right femur, two broken ankles, right foot broken, several ribs on the right side broken, my right lung deflated, facial fractures, massive bleeding in the brain, traumatic brain injury. So when I say I'm happy and blessed to be able to walk, be cognitively competent, actually carry on a conversation, speak what the Lord's done for me. I'm here, I got this. Rather than, see, I had a passenger, she was ejected and killed, and the Lord forgave me. He showed me mercy, he showed me his grace, and he showed me his loving kindness,
sure,
his faithfulness.
Sure.
He brought me to Teen Challenge to gain a relationship with him rather than a prison cell where I should be or the grave where I should be. Praise God for that.
Thank you for sharing us with that. I mean, your whole life, not only was it turned upside down, but now you've done a complete 360. Now, Madeline, when you hear this young man's testimony, and how does it make you feel as a teenager and knowing how, you know, the different peer pressures that you can experience in high school, and of course, you're going to be going to college soon, you know, how does that encourage you?
His story encourages me a lot because it shows me that God can really take any situation and turn it around. I mean, all of those injuries, I do not know how you made it through that, but it's God's grace that you are here, and I'm amazing. It's amazing to hear your story, and I'm thankful that I got to hear it. And I think this is a great organization. I've seen it work wonders in my own church family, and so it's just great to hear your story, and I'd love to hear it again.
Very good. Thank you so much, AJ. You know, you are a story of redemption, and we're so grateful to have Teen Challenge here in the community because they definitely are truly helping these young people make better decisions and you yourself change for the better.
Yes, ma'am.
This is AJ, ladies and gentlemen, with Teen Challenge.
Hey, everyone, it's Madeline here, and I'm here with Miss Wyatt, and we're going to take a look at her beautiful booth that she has. Miss Wyatt, why don't you tell us about your booth and why you love Christmas season so much and how you got started doing this? I mean, it's beautiful. Just tell us about it.
Thank you so much. I mean, I just really been doing this a long time. It's kind of like my side hustle, I guess, side business.
I'm saying.
And Christmas really excites me because it's really fun to decorate.
Oh, yes.
And I like to help people with decorations around their house.
Yes.
And it's kind of relaxing. I have a she shed, and I just go out to my she shed, and I get busy making things.
That is wonderful. I love she sheds, and I can see that you utilize yours well. Why don't you show us some of your pieces? I mean, they're gorgeous.
Well, I like this one. Okay, because it says Jesus is the reason for the season.
And that is very true.
Yes. Okay, and it's just a simple piece. You can sit it on the mantle, sit it on a shelf, or hang it on the door.
I love it. I mean, I would suggest anyone to come down here and buy this. The Jingle Mingle is a great place to be, and we just thank you so much for talking to us.
All right, thank you.
Merry Christmas. Hey, everyone, it's Madeline here with Miss Mandy. We're going to have her talk about her business here down at the Jingle Mingle.
Hey, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Now, will you explain to us about your business, how you got started, and what gave you the drive to do this?
When I lived in the Carolinas, I started taking elderberry syrup from a lady that made it there. It's so good for you. It boosts your immune system, helps you keep from getting sick. I moved back here, not a lot of people know about it, so I started making it and started selling it. So that's how I got started.
That's interesting. So you really educated the community on this specific topic. And so how long have you been selling this for?
2.5 years.
Oh, and I can see that you do very well. Now, can you explain some of these to us? Are there different flavors? Are there different?
It's just one flavor. It's got, these are all of my ingredients that's in it. I use local raw honey that's harvested here in Lawrence County. So it's good for your sinuses and good for all of your nasal stuff. It's not concentrated. It's not a mix. You take it just like it is.
Now that is interesting. And it's good to see that you use other companies from local businesses here down. I'm sure we'll talk to many other local businesses here at the Jingle Mingle. And it's been great talking to you, Miss Manity. And Merry Christmas
Merry
to you.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, everyone. I have Mr. Chad here down at the Jingle Mingle. And he's going to explain his business to us and how long he's been doing it.
Yeah, well, my name's Chad Drew. And I own Silver Smoke Farms, LLC. What we are is we're a Christmas tree farm. We're located right outside of East Dublin, halfway in between East Dublin and Wrightsville. It's an up-and-coming farm. It hasn't opened yet. I still got about 3 more years before my trees are big enough to harvest. But with the trees, my wife decided she wanted to make candles to go along with it. So we got an early head start on it, and this is her second year of making candles. And what she has here, she's got soy candles. She makes them all from our home, and she got a shop in the backyard. But every single one of them here are Christmas-scented candles. She sells year-round. She's got spring, fall, now this is Christmas. She just does it as a hobby on the side, so she enjoys it.
Okay, and can you tell us about some of the most popular Christmas scents that y'all have?
Sure. People this time of year, they love the tree smells. Balsam fir, Christmas tree farm. As a matter of fact, we sold all the balsam fir that we have. The only thing we have left are wax melts. We sell 12-ounce jars, 10-ounce jars, we've got wax melts, scent shots, and little 4-ounce jars. So balsam fir is by far the most popular. People like the tree smells. North Pole here is like a peppermint smell. People like that for their home. There's a lot of different types. If you like gingerbread smell, we got that. So it's whatever your flavor is that you like, people. We've usually got a scent for it. So.
Well, it's great to see that you're going to have another local business here and open a few years. And it's good to see that you've started early. I can tell that a lot of people in Lawrence County love candles, and everyone loves to shop local. so it's great that y'all are down here at the Jingle Mingle. And it's been great talking to you.
Yes, you too. You too.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
When your ability to get up out of a chair, stand, walk, and do routine activities without hurting every day, having to take Tylenol, Motrin, or Aleve to get through the day, then it's time to come see us. Again, if you're avoiding activities, you're not going to do things with your friends or your family or your children, then you should not let it impact your life like that. We have things from medications to injections to surgery. A lot of people, I think, are scared to come see us initially because they're not ready for surgery. 85% of the people that I see in my office, I'm treating with something other than surgery. It's that small group of people at the end of their disease that are getting knee and hip replacements. So don't be afraid at least to come and let us check it for you.
Here at Stepping Stone, you are never alone. If you or someone you know has been a victim of sexual assault, please call our fully confidential crisis number at 478-595-8339.
Hey everyone, it's Madeline here, and I'm here with Dr. Rhonda Hightower and Miss Rhonda Walker, and they're here down at the Jingle Mingle, and they're going to share with us what they do in Lawrence County and how they help our community. Would you like to share with us, Miss Rhonda?
Well, we're just excited to be down here tonight and have the opportunity to, we've got books, we're giving away books with activities and hot chocolate, and we have some snowmen down here that are running around, and we're reading with children, so we're excited to be a part of the Jingle Mingle, and I'll let Dr. Hightower tell you more about Literacy in Lawrence.
All right. Dr. Hightower, now what is it that Literacy in Lawrence County does for the community?
For the past 3 years, we have partnered with people in our community, great, great partners. Downtown Dublin is one of them.
Yes.
To look for opportunities like this to make literacy more visible, and more valued in Lawrence County. And just as we were talking, a little boy over here ran up to his mama with a book that he got from us and said, "Look what I got." So that's what it's all about right there.
It's great to see kids in our community get excited about learning. And I know that Miss Rhonda here has had a personal impact on my life. And it's great to see that they are continuing this legacy. Thank you for coming down to the Jingle Mingle. And it's Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Hey everyone, I'm here with Miss Lindsay and she works at Fairview Park Hospital. Miss Lindsay, would you like to share with us what you do at the hospital and what the hospital is doing on here at the Jingle Mingle tonight?
Sure, Madeline. Well, first of all, happy holidays. Merry Christmas to everybody. So happy to be out here this year. We've had a great crowd out here, so many people. I have been with Fairview Park Hospital for a little over 5 years as the director of marketing. And tonight we're out here just giving out some free safety bracelets, which are glow, which kids love. We also had some light up wands. We've got glow sticks. Really just wanted to have a good time and have fun and just good family fun down here. Everybody's having a great time.
And I can tell y'all have tons of Christmas spirit. I've seen kids running around everywhere with these glow bracelets on, and I might get one myself after this interview.
Absolutely.
What do you do at the hospital specifically? What is your job? How do you help the community in general? And would you mind telling us about that?
Absolutely. So I feel like I have the best job in the world. I tell people I would do it for free, but I got to pay my bills. So, but what I get to do is to go and tell people about all the great services that Fairview Park offers. We have over 45 service lines of care and services for people to receive health that will help them have better lives. So that's part of our job, is letting people know what we offer. Another part of what we do is we go out to community events and we just are involved in the community. We want to give back and we want to provide experiences and things for kids and families to do together. So that's a lot of fun. And then also, if you're not following us, please follow us on our Facebook page and our Instagram page and all the pages. So we run all the social media for the hospital, and we're also involved in lots of different events. We have the parade coming up and lots of fun things. So
yes, I know I'm excited for the parade. It's been great talking to you, and it's great to see how y'all keep the community safe and really help our community in general.
Absolutely.
Thank you for talking with me, Ms. Lindsay.
Thanks, Madeline.
Merry Christmas. Hey everyone, it's Madeline here with Alex down here downtown at the tree lighting. Now Alex, what are you doing downtown here at the Jingle Mingle tonight?
I'm with Lawrence Literacy, and we're passing out books to children so that they can take them home and read. And I'm just here volunteering with a few others to help with that.
Now, I've seen a lot of you guys reading here out tonight, and it's been great to see the older youth get involved with the younger youth. It's a really great experience, and I think it's a really good bonding experience to combine each generation. Now, what are you looking forward to most this Christmas, I might ask?
I'm looking forward to spending some time with my family and just being able to cook and eat and open presents and spend time with them this season.
Now, I know that's our fave, spending time with our family and eating. I know that's one of my favorite things to do. So it's a great time down here at the Jingle Mingle, and just it's great to see everyone here down at the Jingle Mingle and spending time together. Thank you. Hello, everyone. I'm here with Miss Susanna, the art show. Now, Miss Susanna, what kind of art do you do?
I'm an oil painter.
Okay, and now how long have you been doing oil paintings?
It's been about 21 years.
Oh my goodness. Now, can you tell us a little bit about this beautiful painting behind us?
Well, I painted this beginning of school, and I just really was getting into the blue and white frame, or not frames, but vases, so I decided to paint. Kroger had some flowers on sale, and I said, I saw a painting coming on, so I spent about a month working on it. So.
Oh my goodness. It is beautiful. And now, can you tell me what type of flowers are these? Just an arrangement?
I am going to have to brag. My son got the Daisy Award. He's a nurse at Fairview Park. And so the far left daisies were his flowers. And you know, he's my son, so he's like, flowers? I said, I like those flowers. So I painted them.
Now, that is nice of you to incorporate.
The rest were Kroger.
Well, it's beautiful to see that you incorporate things that your sons give you, and that's so sweet. Now, it's been great talking to you, Miss Suzanne. Good to see your artwork here in Lawrence County, and I can see many people down here enjoying your artwork. Thank you.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell swing and jingle bells ring. Snowing and blowing up bushels.